in the loop. Broadcasting all over the world at urbanbroadcastmedia.com, delivering love and inspiration
24/7.
This is UBM Praise. The following show is paid programming and does not necessarily express the views and opinions of Urban Broadcast Media and its subsidiaries.
Thank you for listening to UBM Praise.
Due to some violent content, parental discretion is advised.
Let's go.
A Sir Walter Jones.
Who is it?
A Sir Walter Jones.
What's his name?
A Sir Walter Jones.
Whose show is this?
A Sir Walter Jones.
Who is it?
A Sir Walter Jones.
Say it again.
A Sir Walter Jones.
Who are you with?
A Sir Walter Jones.
One more game.
A Sir Walter Jones.
The Sir Walter Jones Show. Co-host Alvin Carter. We are a Christian talk show in where we tackle all the hot topics in a believer's walk.
A Sir Walter Jones.
Who is it?
A Sir Walter Jones.
What's his name?
A Sir Walter Jones.
Whose show is this?
A Sir Walter Jones.
Who is it?
A Sir Walter Jones.
Say it again.
Special lady.
Who are you singing first and second?
No, Harry, I'm singing second.
And a very exciting girl.
Al, bring that bass out, man.
Hey, man, I'll bring it out a little bit more.
You gotta be a special lady.
Let's get down on some harmony. Come on.
Cause you got me sitting on top of the world. Sitting on top of the world.
Somehow I knew it would be you. Change my gray skies to blue, and it was strange when you called my name. Ever since that day, I haven't been the same. Ooh, before I met you, my sun didn't want to shine. But no matter what you do, and I hope you understand me. Every word I say is true, cause I love you, baby.
Impossible for you.
there are no words.
Everybody, welcome to the Sir Walter Jones Show. This is Sir Walter, and we are in the studio jamming to the hits. I was sitting here just grooving and swaying from side to side. My guest, he's popping his fingers. I don't know. We need to find a way if we can implement some of these songs back into the sanctuary, and we change some lyrics or something. I don't know what's gonna happen because y'all don't write songs like that no more. I don't get it. There's something about love songs that not just move the ladies, but it also moves the men, and that's what we're going to talk about today. Our question of the day on Men's Chronicles, y'all, is why won't he marry me? Why won't he marry me? This is the question that's been asked me from a lot of the ladies down through the years, and today we're going to try to figure out. We got four men on the panel on the round table, and we're going to start digging deep into this topic. We got a good one here, y'all. We got a good one. Okay, so I got my dear friend Alvin Carter, who is the co-host of this show, and he's running, trying to make 100, because 99 and a quarter won't do.
75 cent either.
No. And I think I saw Art Lewis walk in the door, and phone rang, and he ran back out.
Yeah, one his wives.
One his wives. Yeah, that's why he must be. Yeah, and a man who traveled all the way, y'all, from Canada. All the way.
3 blocks south of Alaska.
At least 3 blocks south of Alaska.
That's right.
My good friend and my brother, Joshua Randolph. How you doing, brother?
I'm doing well, sir. Sir Walker. I'm just excited to be on the show.
Man, thank you, brother. Thank you so much, man. I tell you, I want y'all to know that this is a good brother. He and we'll go into a little more insight of who he is in the show. But I met him this year. He was gracious enough. I got called in. Monica Davis, who is another good friend of mine, who belonged to the same church that I belonged to back in the day at Faith Temple out there in Evanston. Shout out to Bishop Moody. She linked up in the ministry with him out there in the northern hemisphere, Alvin. And she told me about the praise team that they have, and she asked me to come out and kind of give him some pointers, and I did on a Saturday. And I called him because you never go to somebody's house, Alvin.
Okay.
All right. And the man of the house is not home.
Yeah, he ain't safe. Ask Joseph and Potiphar.
Yeah, you see what I'm saying. You don't go
especially
to somebody.
They look as good as you.
Especially look as me.
Yeah.
You don't invite people you know, to your house, and the man of the house don't know that you're there. And so I told the, you know, the ladies to call him and text him, let him know I'm here, and I want to talk to him, and I did. And it was right around the time for my concert was getting ready to happen, my birthday concert.
Okay.
Yeah. So when you saw him that night, we had only known each other, you know, just a few weeks prior.
Okay.
Yeah. Matter of fact, that was the first time you and I had physically met.
Yes.
Yeah, it was the first time we had. Yeah.
That's a special day.
Same here. Yes, that's right. Same here. You were in the front row.
Yeah.
So
that's the only seat that'll hold me.
Right. So he was so gracious. You know, when I talked to him on the phone, he said, come on. Yeah, because I invited his choir to sing.
Okay.
And that was his praise team up there. And he was so gracious, man. He had never seen me, had never heard of me, but he was just that gracious enough, said, yes, I want them to come and support you. And I said, I got to get him on the show. So he here. Took him forever to get here because, you know, he coming from Canada. But he's here, man. You're doing good, Doc.
I'm doing well. I mean, I had to call one of my thugs. You know, I'm coming way from the north. I had to call one of my thugs from the church, Thug Love. I say thug mean truly humbled under God.
Yes, sir.
I called one of my thugs. I said, is this a safe neighborhood? And will I be okay?
Wow.
She said, Pastor, we got you.
That's good. It's good to be friends with thugs still.
Amen.
I think Jesus alluded to that in scripture about being friends with mammon, I think. Well, not mammon, but with the worldly folk. Because you may need them one day.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
That's the road.
Yeah.
Samaritan road. You know, the good Samaritan
road. That's right. Mm-hmm. That's right. Right. So we're going to chime in on this question here about why won't he marry me? This is a question that's asked by women. Now, I played a montage of songs from our past and somewhat of our present. These are wonderful songs that are sung by men. And women usually ask the question, why aren't men emotional? Okay. But listen to these.
We are emotional.
Well, if you listen to the songs.
We're very emotional.
These are men singing these songs. These are men who wrote these songs.
Right.
So apparently they must be emotional.
Right.
And I specifically, there you go.
Woo!
Come on,
baby.
Now, who,
girl, you know I'm about to go in now.
I mean,
the bathroom.
Right. How could you possibly sing like that, write like that if you're not emotional?
Right.
Okay, so there's something that these men are saying, and I specifically chose these songs because these songs are talking really about how they want to dedicate their lives to this one woman.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, whether they want to get married to her, or maybe they're already married, or they're just boyfriend, girlfriend, and he's just dedicating his life to her with the hopes that possibly marriage will come. You know, we interpret songs on the best way we can.
The best way we can.
Okay. Because a couple of those songs I had to stop in the middle of it, because they went left field on me. Okay. But let's Facebook is chiming in, you guys. V Rogers is here. Maiden Sweet Ray of Sunshine. I like saying that. It gets this
Sweet Ray.
Yeah. I love it. Darwin is here. Lori Lawson. Tamara Mills, who Tamara's show is the number one show.
Oh, wait a minute, man.
Today.
They talked about her show in our lodge meeting Saturday.
Did they really?
The brothers was listening.
Get out of here.
Oh, my God.
Wow.
We had a gathering with the OESs and the brothers. And
is that right?
There was a corner of us.
Really?
Over there talking. The sister's like, what y'all talking about?
Wow.
We had forgot about them, and it was engulfed in conversation about that show. Can you believe it?
That's amazing. I get the stats every morning, and her show keeps climbing and climbing and climbing. So we thank God for her coming in from Indianapolis and being a guest on our show. She talked about the former lesbian life, and her testimony really blessed people. It's blessing a lot of people. Larry Brown is on the web, and you got Michelle Thomas. And so we're giving you guys a shout out, and thank you for listening in. The rebroadcast will be up tonight on Spreaker.com, and there'll be more chiming in. Okay, so let's get right to it. Now, you men, out of the 4 men in this room, I'm the only one that's single. Okay, all right. Yes, God rest my soul. Yeah. Now,
lucky you.
But I've been married before. All right. Matter of fact, I went down that road. A little less than Art Lewis over there.
Okay.
Art is a professional.
That's right.
Old road again.
Art is a professional man.
I'm a professional married man.
Yeah, he's professional. Doc Randolph, let me give you the rules of engagement here. What we do is we pretty much just we're very transparent.